everyone, Justin here. You caught me sorting through some wood left over from my old projects here in my workshop. I've been learning how to use woodworking tools like a hammer, a saw, and even some power tools. I'm trying to decide what to make for my next project. Oh, I know. A present for Mia. She's been helping me out so much lately. I'd love to make her a thank you gift. But what? Maybe looking through this pile of wood scraps will spark some inspiration. What do we have here? It looks like these wood pieces all have different angles. If I'm trying to build Mia a gift, I'm gonna need to focus on angles because they're the foundation of good woodworking. They help ensure anything I build will be stable enough to not fall over. I better figure out the different types of angles and how they work together to make Mia's present. Looking at these three angles, what similarities do you see? How would you define the word angle? Take a few moments to write down your thoughts in your guided notes. Did you notice that each angle forms where the ends of two pieces of wood meet? An angle is defined as the space between two rays that share a common endpoint. In this case, our shared endpoint is the nail connecting the two pieces of wood. Angles are measured in degrees using this circle symbol. The angle highlighted here, for example, is 30 degrees. This next angle is special. Where in the world have you seen angles that look like this before? Take a minute now and jot down a few ideas in your guided notes. You see these kinds of angles in squares and rectangles, on windows, bookshelves, and even at the base of houses. These are right angles. Right angles form perfectly square corners, which make them great for providing strong and sturdy support in structures, like my house. What makes right angles special is that they measure exactly 90 degrees. Right angles are easy to spot using a common tool, a sheet of paper. Just make sure that it has sharp corners, not round ones. Simply hold the corner of your paper up to the angle. And if it fits perfectly, it's a right angle measuring 90 degrees. But what about those other two angles? Are either of them right angles? Hint, you might want to grab a sheet of paper to help you. Well, first, let's fit a corner of our paper into each angle and see whether either of them matches. This first one doesn't fit, and the second one also doesn't fit. So neither of them are right angles. How are these angles different from right angles? Write down your thoughts in your guided notes. One thing I noticed is angle one is open wider than angle two. When I put the corner of my paper into angle one, there was extra space left in the angle. Angle two is narrower, and when I put the corner of my paper into angle two, I couldn't even see the angle anymore. It was all covered up. Angle one is called an obtuse angle. Look at it compared to the 90 degree right angle. How do you think we could define obtuse angle? Write your definition in your guided notes. Well, the obtuse angle is definitely more open than the right angle. If we fit the corner of our paper in there, we have extra space left over. That means an obtuse angle is an angle that is greater than 90 degrees. Take a look at this other angle we found in the pile. It's called an acute angle. Comparing it to the right angle and using the corner of our paper, how would you define acute angle? Don't forget to write down your idea in your guided notes. Yep, since the acute angle is less open than the right angle, and our paper covers it up entirely, that means it's smaller than the right angle. The definition of an acute angle is an angle that is less than 90 degrees. Well, that's been a great reminder of angle vocabulary, but it hasn't helped me think of an idea for Mia's gift. I'll keep digging and see what else I could find. Ooh, these are all stuck together. Let me untangle them. Ah, there we go. Okay, now your turn. Can you identify these angles as obtuse, right, or acute? Well, this first angle is open much bigger than the angle on the corner of my paper. If it's bigger, it's obtuse, since obtuse means greater than 90 degrees. This middle angle is right because it perfectly matches a corner of my paper. And the last angle is acute because it's smaller than a right angle. How about this one? Wait a second, is this even an angle? Look back at our definition of the word angle from earlier. What do you think? Is this an angle or not? Share your answer and reason why in your guided notes. Well, at first glance, I'm thinking, no, it's not an angle. All the angles we saw before had two lines meeting at a place. This seems to just be one line not meeting anywhere. However, what if I showed you how this piece of wood was made? Take a look at this. It looks like we took two right angles and put them together. How many degrees is a right angle? 90 degrees. Now, what happens if we add two 90 degree angles together? 90 plus 90 is 180. Since this angle is made of two right angles, it measures 180 degrees. This is still two pieces joined together. It's just harder to see because they end up laying flat, making it a straight line. That's why we call this type of angle a straight angle. The definition of a straight angle is a type of angle that makes a straight line and measures exactly 180 degrees. Take a moment to write down this definition now. All right, let's see what else we have left in the pile. Hold your horses, this is different. We have two pieces of wood nailed together, but they've made two different angles. When we use words like acute, obtuse, and right, they describe one angle. However, now we have two angles, so we need to discuss how they relate to one another. We call this an angle relationship when we talk about the connection between two angles. Okay, so how are these two angles related then? Well, it kind of looks like that straight angle we saw earlier, remember? There are two angles in this figure, here and here. But what overall angle do they make when we put them together? It seems to make a straight line, straight angle on the bottom. This type of relationship is called supplementary. Two angles are supplementary if they add up to 180 degrees and form a straight angle when you put them together. Make sure you have that written down in your guided notes now. There's only a few things left in the scrap pile. We might as well take a look at all of them before I decide what to make Mia. How about this one? What kind of angle is created by the two smaller angles this time? Yes, these angles form a right angle. We call these angles complementary angles. Two angles are complementary if they add up to 90 degrees and form a right angle when put together. Take a second to fill in the definition of complementary in your guided notes. One trick I like to use is complementary and corner. Both start with C, and since right angles are perfect corners and complementary angles add up to right angles, it's a good way to remember their connection. All right, last piece, help me out. Do these two angles form complementary or supplementary angles? Well, first, what's the overall angle? Yes, these angles create a straight angle, which means they're supplementary. Supplementary, straight. Huh, what a great way to remember these ones too. Ooh, this scrap wood pile was full of angles. Today, we learned that with a simple piece of paper, we can identify 90 degree right angles, as well as acute angles, which are smaller than 90 degrees, obtuse angles, which are larger than 90 degrees, and straight angles, which measure 180 degrees. We also explored complementary angle pairs that form right angles, and supplementary angle pairs that form straight angles. All this angle talk has inspired me to definitely build something for Mia, and it's going to be full of angles. While I draw up the plans, finish your guided notes and work on practice levels 1 through 3. Until next time, keep questioning, keep calculating, and remember, there's math hiding in every corner. See you next time! Ooh.